All right, this is a very interesting subject, and a lot of you responded. You know, this topic takes you from A to B. Every single day, your feet. And getting there isn't always a comfortable experience. So answering many, many Facebook viewers' questions, and by the way, we're going to touch on what was the most popular ones that came in. Dr. Bob Baravarian is here, and he's going to thank you for being here, doctor.
Sure, my
because
pleasure.
This was, we had so many people chime in on our Facebook page with these questions because you need your feet to get around, you're on it, and it's painful. And I share with our first viewer who writes in, this is about plantar fasciitis. We're going to touch on four of them. There's of the four most common problems.
Yep.
Plantar fasciitis is the first one. This is from Kim. I hope I say your name right, Kim. Kim Seneth Ornelius. Here's the question. My plantar fasciitis is killing me, going on 9 years in my left foot. The pain never goes away. Cortisone shots only work for a few months. I tried orthotics. Surgery the only option?
So first, let's just talk about plantar fascia. The plantar fascia is a ligament that runs from the bottom of the heel to the toes, mm-hmm. and it's responsible for supporting the arch.
Mm-hmm.
So as the Achilles pulls and as the ground pushes, the fascia gets stretched, and then you start to get little microscopic tears. After about 6 months, the body just won't respond anymore to the inflammation in the area, and you get a chronic scar tissue that develops.
Oh.
So you have to rev up the body's healing process. And
how?
Some of the more interesting things are platelet-rich plasma injection. You hear all these athletes who are getting injections.
Mm-hmm.
We draw your blood, we pull out the growth factors, we inject it, and it helps restart the healing process.
Wow.
One level up from that is actually using your own stem cells. And we use your stem cells to help restart the healing process. So surgery doesn't always have to be cutting the fascia. Oh. That's a last resort.
Yeah.
There's a lot of things you can do before you get to that point.
Yeah. Right, Debbie, you might be happy to hear about that because
so
I know you.
Yeah.
We've already bonded.
You already did?
I mean, the minute he walked in, I was like, Doc, please, you need to help me. Yeah. I've had it for over 15 years. I have had plantar fasciitis so bad. Doc,
on and off or consistently?
I have a low-grade pain at all times to the point where I would get a headache because my feet hurt so bad. And my mom always said, oh, it's because you had high-heel shoes. And it's not. I wasn't wearing high-heel shoes to high school.
Right.
Why did I develop
that? I have the same
that?
Thing. Yeah. And it's not from high-heel shoes.
No, it's not.
Yeah, exactly.
At first, I thought it wasn't. But mine comes and goes. So can you address both of these? Like, what causes this to come and go and return and why?
So first is, if you wear a high heel, then your Achilles starts to get tight. And then when you go into a flat position, in a flat shoe, the Achilles starts to pull. And then you start to get tearing of the fascia. In a case like yours, let's say you wear a flip-flop or you're on a weekend and you do more activity or an activity that you're not used to, like a hike where you have to get through your stride more.
Yeah.
You can cause an irritation of the fascia. And if you don't know how to stretch, wear an insole to protect it, wear nice stiff-soled shoes, wedges, platforms are much better than the soft, rubbery shoes.
Hmm.
You'll start to have an inflammatory process, and if you don't take care of it, it'll become chronic.
Right. So maybe it was because I know Mark was an athlete as well. Could have been from being an athlete when we were in high school?
I mean, athletics can cause you to have more problems, but if you take care of it, especially with stretching, that's the single best help.
Okay.
And also stiff-soled shoes.
All right. Well, our next guest, person who wrote in went to that question exactly, and you've answered it, but she said, I can't seem to get it to heal completely. Is there anything more I can do to get rid of this forever? Can you get rid of it forever?
Yes. Yeah, so we, at our institute, we see about 3,000 cases a year. We keep very close tabs on what works. Mm-hmm. And you'll be surprised. Stretching, massaging the area of the heel that's most painful, icing, rolling on a frozen water bottle, wearing nice supportive shoes, women wearing a tiny bit of a heel to take some of the stretch off the fascia makes a huge difference. 80% of our patients get better without an injection, without surgery. So it's all about the consistency of stretching first thing in the morning and kind of wearing good quality shoes.
All right, we're moving on to Neuroma. Right?
Neuroma.
What is
saying that
neuroma?
Right? Neuroma.
What is that,
first of all?
So neuroma is usually a nerve that gets pinched between the two bones between the third and fourth toes. It can be between the second and third toes, but the third and fourth toes are most common. And you get a shooting pain into the toes, and it feels like you're walking on like a little painful pebble.
Mm.
Usually patients say when they wear a certain type of shoe that's tight, or if they wear softer shoes, they feel the pinging of the nerve more and more.
Well, this is from Teresa Dawn. I have mild RSD and am suffering now Raynaud's, am I saying that right?
Raynaud's?
In all toes on the right foot. What can I do to help My toes hurt bad. First of all, what is RSD?
RSD is a very, very strange category where the nerves in the foot just get whacked out, or the nerves in the hand. It can be anywhere in the body, and you get pain, tingling, shooting pains, and it's really, really difficult to deal with. Mm-hmm. Most common treatments for RSD, one is physical therapy, two is really epidural injections or nerve injections, almost like pushing the reset button on your nervous system. Mm-hmm. By giving an injection to calm the nerve, you allow it a little bit of time to rest, and you hope that it resets.
But
it can be devastating at times.
You have to repeat it? You have to go through your whole life having epidurals?
No, it's kind of like that computer where sometimes you push the power button, turn it off, and turn it back on, and it's fine.
Wow, yeah.
And sometimes it can be a lifelong issue. RSD is very, very difficult to deal with.
Okay, well, Teresa, thank you for sharing your foot with the world.
Now,
that was hers.
All right. Are we moving on to bunions?
You're looking at me?
Yeah.
Okay.
All right.
Bunions.
Yes.
Okay. Other than surgery, what are some ways to ease the pain from bunions? I have some friends that they're gnarly, and both feet.
Send them my way.
Yeah. No. What causes bunions, and why do we get bunions?
A bunion's a hereditary condition. The bone that leads to the big toe drifts out, and as it does that, the toe begins to drift in. So you get a increased angle between these two bones, and it's really a looseness of this joint. So we do a few different types of surgeries for bunions. One is to cut the bone and shift it over.
Right.
With a screw.
Shave it? Do you shave it?
Whoa.
No,
just
move it back.
Wow.
Just move it back?
Yeah. The other one is to move the entire bone back, and we basically secure this joint so that the bunion doesn't come back.
I've had my poor friends have had
that's
it.
That's a before
and
after picture. You can see.
It takes forever. It took forever, and it was so painful for them.
Color.
I feel so bad.
I have a question because I have bunions. I do. That's why I'm here, because I want to talk to you about that. But, you know, it runs in my family. So my grandmother had it.
Is it hereditary?
It is.
It is.
Yeah, so you have a looseness of this joint, and it causes you to get a bunion.
Okay, sorry.
And but also, because of it, I think I have flat feet now, and I was also a dancer. How much does that have to do? Like, are all those things kind of contributing?
So definitely, if you have flat feet and you roll in, you're going to put more stress on the joint, and the bunion will shift. You have to have somewhat of a hereditary condition to get it.
Mm-hmm.
More importantly, as you dance, you're also barefoot, putting abnormal stress through your foot, and that causes it to form to a certain extent.
So is the only solution an operation for me?
So if you come in my office and we're talking, the first thing I say is don't have surgery unless you have pain. That being said,
which I have had for years.
Yeah, softer, supple shoes, the leather on top, and a nice firm sole allows for better support and actually can accommodate the deformity. So stay away from patent shoes or hard leathers.
Okay.
But surgery, nowadays, you're up and about walking right away. You're usually back in a shoe in about 3 or 4 weeks.
Okay.
And the success rate's 95%. So if it bugs you, you gotta just nip it in the bud early.
I'm holding it off as long as I possibly can. So
doesn't bother you enough. Leave it alone.
Okay. Let's talk about flat feet now.
Okay, I'm gonna jump to DD Long. And she's writing it about flat feet, not hers, but her son's. My son suffers greatly because it can be quite painful to be on his feet moving about. And get this, he's only 20 years old.
Oh.
So you can't correct flat feet, can you?
Sure, you can. But again, the simple way of correcting it is, number one, firm soled shoes. So the more firm the shoe is, the less the foot has to work. Number two is you can have an orthotic made or an arch support made to support the foot and put it in the right position. So you're gonna be doing a ride.
Yeah, you have flat feet?
Yeah, terribly flat feet. And you know what, and when I started my career when I was 18, I was in the kitchen standing for 14, 15 hour days.
What kind of shoes did you wear?
So I was wearing we would call them a bluntstone. It was just like a work boot, and they were heavy, and there was no shape on the inside of them. But then I moved to the Birkenstock shoes, and they had an arch, but I still felt that there was issues with my lower back. I felt like everything that I did, it was accentuated for my foot because they pronate, they roll in.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And now because I do have that ride, I do worry, am I putting tension, even though I'm on a bike and there's no compression, am I gonna give myself long-term issues?
So the first thing is that in a bike shoe, almost every athlete that bikes long distances, they have an arch support made for the shoe. And number two, you actually will cant your lever. So where you clip in, they actually will cant it so that you're biking directly over your knee and not at an angle.
I throw my knees when I ride. Even when you ride with your knees in, I feel like they roll in unnaturally, actually. So that makes a lot of sense to me.
Yeah. So you can correct flat feet.
Sure.
And there's multiple surgeries. The one thing with people, especially younger children, that's important is sometimes the bones don't separate when you're a kid, and that can be a problem that needs to be dealt with. But otherwise, start with stiff shoes and an insole in the shoe.
More information available for you. If you'd like to, you can go to footandankleinstitute.com there at the bottom. Thank you so much,
Doctor.
Very popular subject with our viewers and with all of us here as well.